This is All She Fears, a Jade Savage FBI suspense thriller, book one, written by Molly Black, read by Caroline. Prologue. The moon cast its ethereal glow upon the greenhouse, turning its glass panes into a mosaic of light and shadow. The man slipped inside, the door closing with a whisper behind him, as if the very night conspired to keep his secret. Shrouded in silence, he moved through the verdant labyrinth, his gaze lingering on the bizarre silhouettes of exotic plants that thrived in this climate he'd created. The air was thick with the scent of damp earth and living greenery, a stark contrast to the sterile world outside. "Beautiful," he murmured, "how something so deadly can look so innocent." His words were barely audible, lost amidst the rustle of foliage as he brushed past a frond that recoiled at his touch. His gloved hands, meticulous and steady, reached toward a plant that seemed to pulse with a dark allure. Its leaves, veined with crimson, shivered as he delicately extracted the fluid hidden within, a venom powerful enough to still a beating heart. His smile was private, knowing. "This is my art," he thought, "my contribution to a misguided world." Every careful movement was an act of precision, an expression of his unspoken philosophy. To him, it wasn't merely poison. It was a catalyst for change, a silent scream against society's decay. "They will listen. After tonight, they'll have no choice." The air was thick with the heady scent of earth and life as he worked, the sound of each drop falling into the vial, a whispered promise of the change to come. With hands steady as a surgeon's, he measured the poison, his gloved fingers deftly operating the pipette with an artisan's precision. He had to be careful. Every great transformation required patience. The tiny container was capped and carefully wiped down. Every tool he used followed suit, swabbed clean of any damning evidence. His breaths were even, his heart a drumbeat of calm control. Years of preparation, nothing left to chance. He allowed himself the luxury of pride. It was not arrogance if it was earned. The plan was flawless, every detail etched into his mind with the clarity of a diamond. There would be no slip-ups, no mistakes. He was the ghost in the machine, undetectable, unstoppable. Now all he had to do was enact his plan. He stood, taking in the vibrant greenery that surrounded him. It was here, in this glass cathedral of natural wonders, that he found solace, strength, and purpose. The plants around him were silent witnesses to his innermost thoughts, the only ones that knew of the impending storm he was about to unleash. For a moment he was Adam in Eden, uncorrupted and powerful. "From this sanctuary, I will cleanse the world," he thought, conviction burning in his chest. "They'll wake from their complacency. They'll have to face the ugliness they've ignored for so long." He took one last look around the greenhouse. There, on the edge of the rusted workbench, lay the newspaper. The world outside these glass walls intruded upon his oasis, its presence an unwelcome reminder of the task at hand. The pop star Olivia Black's image stared back at him, her blue eyes bright even in the dim light, the headline screaming about her latest record-breaking hit. "World sensation?" he scoffed quietly, his voice laced with disdain. "More like a world delusion. He could feel it, the pull of his mission, the urgent need to rectify what others celebrated." Olivia, with her artificial charm and manufactured melodies, had become the embodiment of all that was wrong with society. She was the siren leading the masses astray, and he had been chosen to silence her song. The thought brought a smile to his face. "Goodbye, Olivia. The world won't miss you." With a swift, almost dismissive flick of his foot, he sent the newspaper skittering onto the floor. It settled out of sight, much like Olivia would soon be, out of sight, out of mind, erased from the collective consciousness. His heart raced with anticipation, the thrill of the hunt igniting his senses. He imagined the confusion, the fear, the inevitable realization that would dawn upon the world once they discovered their idol had fallen, a mortal after all. Turning on his heel, he disappeared into the shadows, the future he was crafting for them all concealed within the vial in his pocket. The night was his confidant, and together they would rewrite history. Chapter 1. 1 month later, morning sun spilled through the floor-to-ceiling windows, casting a golden hue over Jade Savage as she did push-up after push-up, sending herself to the brink of exhaustion. 148! 149! She whispered.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.